Hello, and welcome to another Interpreter's Reveal. Today, I'd like to share with you the very recently released feature on Zoom that allows for relay interpreting. It looks like the relay part works fairly well. It's not so great for listening to your boothmate, but let's take a look at it and talk about what the issues are at the end. Here we are on the new Zoom interface. As we can see, we have our channel toggle, just like we had in the Zoom that we've all been working on throughout the pandemic. So I can simply click to change languages. Those are my outgoing languages. The novelty here, however, is this one, listening in. And here I can choose the main audio, that is the floor, the speaker, or I can click on this little arrow here, and a drop-down menu will appear, English, or in this case, Portuguese, which is the third language that we have available for this conference. But let's assume that we now have a Portuguese speaker on the floor. Now, if I'm the active interpreter, I will need to continue to work into Spanish. But if I don't have Portuguese in my combination, I'll need to take relay from the Portuguese to English interpreter. To do that, I will then select English as my listening in, and I will remain in Spanish as my speaking to. And that is how the relay function works. The new relay function works on Zoom. That part is really straightforward. It gets a little more complicated, however, if I want to monitor my own boothmate. That is not quite so straightforward. Let me see if I can walk you through it. Let's assume now that we have a Spanish speaker on the floor. In this case, the President of Mexico. I'm listening to the original audio, the floor, the main audio. And in this case, however, I would not be interpreting into Spanish because this is a Spanish speaker. I would need to change my outgoing language to English. As we can see from the interpreter list, my partner is also going into English. Now, let's assume that my partner has indeed commenced interpreting, and I would like to monitor her output. Well, I could, one would think, simply go here to this selector and use the drop-down list to select English, but I can't. Why? Because I am speaking into, or would be speaking into, the English channel if my microphone were live. To be able to hear my partner's rendition, I have to be sure that my speaking to language, the language that I would be broadcasting into if my mic were live, is the opposite. So if I have selected Spanish as my outgoing, even though it's being spoken on the floor, I now see that English has appeared as one of my options, and I can indeed listen to my partner.
In this case, we can see that the President of Mexico is speaking. We can hear my interpreting partner who is speaking onto the English channel because I am listening in English. But again, if there were to be a handover at this moment, my outgoing channel would not be the correct one. I would need to switch to English before turning my microphone on to be sure that I am on the correct outgoing channel.
As I said at the beginning of this video, the relay part of this function works fairly well. It's very transparent, very easy to use. You will hear the colleague providing relay at about a volume of 80% and the original at 20%. Not loud enough for it to distract you, but loud enough for you to know at least that it's there. So for relay, it works. That's the good news. Not so great news is that trying to listen to your interpreting partner, your own boothmate, really, it's not there yet. So we still need that additional device, that additional back channel to be able to see and, of course, hear our partner clearly. We want to be able to provide support to our colleague. Hearing them at 20% volume, probably not enough to be able to provide that support, vocabulary, whatever they might need. And plus, there's the implicit risk on Zoom that you might click to turn your microphone on and end up very easily on the wrong channel if you indeed have been listening to your boothmate prior to a handover. So that's it. That's the new relay feature on Zoom.